Hi guys, you are watching Tech Area Network and I am your host Jayanto. Today I gonna do an interesting project on Kali Linux and Windows. You won't believe that Kali Linux will work as an application here on Windows 10. Amazing, right? Let's now move to the practical session. But before that, please subscribe the channel, like the video right here, right now. Right now I am on my Windows 10 PC. First we have to check the Windows 10 version because it needs to have Windows 10 version 1903 build 18362 or higher. To check the Windows version, go to run, type winvar and then select OK. As you can see that I have Windows 10 version 2004 build 19041 which is above the minimum requirement. If you don't have, you just update your Windows 10 version. Let's go further. Here we need to enable the WSL or Windows Subsystem Linux feature. For doing that, open Windows PowerShell as an administrator. Now put this command. Don't worry, I will put all the commands in the description box below. Finally, press Y to confirm for rebooting the machine. So I am back after rebooting the PC. Let's again open Windows PowerShell as an administrator. Here we have to run two more commands. The first one is, this command will enable the virtual machine feature. And then run the second command. Finally restart the PC. So after restarting the PC, we have to download WSL2 Linux kernel from the Microsoft's official website. You can get the download link in the description box below. Once the download has been done, run the package and follow the wizard to complete the installation on Windows 10. After installing the package, run Windows PowerShell again. Here we will set WSL2 as default by putting this command. Now to list any Linux instance running on this Windows 10 PC, we will use this command. As we haven't installed any Linux instance, so we are not getting any installed Linux distribution name here. For installing the Linux over WSL2, we will have to go to the Microsoft Store. As I am going to install Kali Linux distribution here, so I will search for Kali Linux app. You can install Ubuntu or any other available Linux distribution also. So here is the Kali Linux app. Just click on get button, rest of the jobs will be done automatically. So we are ready to launch Kali Linux here. You can launch the instance from here or alternatively you can launch it from the start menu. Type Kali in the search box and here we go. Firstly, we have to set a new username and password for this Kali Linux instance on this Windows 10 PC. Now let's check the Kali Linux OS release by opening the file /etc/os-release. So these are the details of this Kali Linux instance. Now if we go back to Windows PowerShell prompt and run the command to list the running Linux instance over this Windows 10 PC, we should get this Kali Linux instance as a running state. So we can get Kali Linux as a running instance in this Windows 10 PC. So it's pretty cool, right? But till now, we are not getting the graphical user interface at all. So let's fix that. So again, we are back to the Kali Linux console. And here, we will update and upgrade the packages of Kali Linux by using this command. Let's put the password of Kali admin which we have set earlier. Now to open the desktop environment over here, we have to install the package called Kali Desktop XFCE. Set the keyboard layout as English US. Now to get the XRDP feature, run this command, sudo apt install XRDP, put the password of Kali admin. Finally start the XRDP service by using this command, sudo service XRDP start. Okay, so the remote desktop service of this Kali Linux instance has been started. Let's now check the IP address of this instance by running the command ifconfig. So the IP address of this Kali Linux machine is 172.21.1.115. Let's now check the IP address of the Windows 10 PC. It's 172.21.1.120. Let's do a ping test towards the Kali Linux machine. Cool. I am getting the reply from our Kali Linux instance on this Windows 10 PC. Finally, it's time to log into GUI mode of the newly installed Kali Linux over WSL2 on this Windows 10 PC. Let's run MSTSC from this Windows 10 PC and put the IP address of the Kali Linux instance, that is 172.21.1.115. Now we have to put the credentials which we have set earlier in this video for this instance. It's Kali admin and the password of that user. Wow, finally we are on Kali Linux GUI mode, which is actually running on Windows 10. And let's browse for the exciting application of the Kali Linux. Cool, it's all there in this virtual instance of Kali Linux. So please have a try on your Windows 10 and share your experience in the comment box. Thanks for being with us. Please like and share the video and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more exciting videos.